Thought we'd do a little election recap. I know it's Thursday and the dust kind of settled yesterday, but it's interesting that the election is sort of still up in the air as to just how bad it was for Republicans. And I know that it didn't have, look, across the state, there were some bright spots for Republicans. I know in Red Bank, the Republicans swept locally. And I think there was a real disconnect with the assembly elections. But what surprised a lot of people is that you're looking now at four Republican incumbents being swept out of office, which will take the Republican Minority Caucus down to 28, lowest number since 1979. I'm joined by John Bramnick. John is an assemblyman, and he is the head of the Republican Caucus in the assembly. John, good morning. Thanks for joining me on 101.5.
Good morning, Bill. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, so, John, I mean, look, it's tough to have a loss. I've been on the losing end of a couple races myself. It's the toughest thing to do.
I
think you do, John, right?
I think it was in 16, actually.
Yeah, right. A little race for Congress back in the day. But, hey, look, losing is tough, but I think that from a loss can come a great lesson. And the question is, what's the lesson here that Republicans are now going to talk about coming into 17 when we got a gubernatorial election and everybody else is up for re-election?
Bill, Chris Christie and our caucus took on some really tough issues. The main issue in this state is taxes and affordability. So yeah. We took on really, really dangerous third rail issues, including continuing to try to fix the pension.
Yeah.
Well, the assembly was on the top of the ticket. So where did all the special interest money go? Millions and millions of dollars. This is, I call, money that's really mad, because we have addressed and tried to put in bills to kind of fix the system, and all of that special interest money came in. For example, in District 1, $3 to $4 million on TV against $200,000.
Yeah.
We don't have that special interest.
Imagine
money.
$3 million in one assembly race. Shocking.
Yeah, and that's just on television.
Yeah.
So what I'm saying is, first, let's be clear. There is a very big difference between Republicans and Democrats, but the Democrats do have the numbers. This map, even in these districts that you talk about, 11, there's more Democrats in those districts. So when you energize people by using special interest money that we can't compete with, the message is drowned out. Now, let me tell you, I understand we lost, but we do understand that we cannot simply let the taxes continue to go out of control. Now, you talk about the gas tax. Now, let me tell you, the most important issue here is that the Republicans have almost 100 bills to reform all parts of the system. But people don't like that, and you know that. You know that the people do not like these kind of reforms who have special interest money.
No, that, you know, John, you are right on that. I think, and I've said this yesterday, and I'm going to have to jump in a second to get to news, but you and I have talked about this. I think part of the problem is that the message was not simplified, and I go back to April, and I think there was an opportunity for some candidates to just get on board, dig their heels in, and say, look, 7 out of 10 New Jerseyans don't want the gas tax. Let's fight there. And I think there was some confusion as to where would the governor be on that. And in my humble opinion, I think the Republican opposition overthought this election. And I think it went past the real grasp of most people. Not that I think the voters are smarter than anybody gives them credit for. I think the challenge is they're busy and they got a lot going on. And they're starting to now vote with their feet. And that concerns me a lot. This exit plan strategy is very troubling.
Unless we continue with some of these reforms, you're going to see more people leaving.
Yeah.
My concern is this is a message to Democrats saying, hey, you can continue to do the same old, and now we'll see whether they overdo the tax and spend policy that they had in the past.
I'm waiting for the speaker to give us a gas tax in, I don't know, we're counting down the hours now before the gas tax comes in. It's all coming.
Let me say this, I will work with the speaker despite, some of these losses. And I'll tell you, we're not dead yet. Let me tell you right now, as those taxes continue to increase, I think our message will be more clear.
All right. There you go, John. I appreciate you standing up, even despite the loss, and obviously more to come. Always appreciate talking to you on New Jersey 101.5. Have a great day, John. Take care.